Whoa.
Good morning, everybody. Behind me is the city of Tombstone, Arizona.
And I've decided to start my day at one of Tombstone's most famous monuments.
Boot Hill Cemetery.
This was Tombstone's main cemetery until 1884.
It was known back then as the Tombstone Cemetery, but of course, since so many people died such violent deaths in Tombstone, it was known locally as Boot Hill.
Dying with your boots on was old cowboy talk for coming to a sudden and usually very violent death.
You know, the proper way to die being at home, maybe surrounded by loved ones, in bed without boots on.
Look at this. Here's the grave of John Heath, lynched by a Bisbee mob in Tombstone. Here's the Kansas kid, killed in stampede. Six-shooter Jim, shot.
Johnny Wilson, shot.
Hancock, shot. William Grounds, died of wounds.
Marshal Fred White, shot by Curly Bill Brocious.
Someone named Stinging Lizard, shot by Cherokee Hall.
Here's the grave of a man shot by Buckskin Frank Leslie.
Killed, shot, shot, killed.
I can't help but notice a pattern here.
Look at this headstone here, look at this.
Here lies George Johnson, hanged by mistake in 1882. He was right, we was wrong. But we strung him up, and now he's gone.
If that one's not familiar to you, how about this one? Here lies Lester Moore, four slugs from a .44. No less, no more.
I've seen copies of this in like every Halloween graveyard ever.
Every party store with Western-themed decor has a copy of this head marker.
I thought it would be fun, kind of a lark, to go and see some of the more colorful tombstones here.
But the more I look around, the more graves I see simply marked unknown.
And the more I look at these graves and think about the fact that these were real people who came to a sudden and often very violent end,
the more this gets kind of depressing.
These dudes and dudettes were way more hardcore than I could ever hope to be.
They lived in and settled places most people didn't even have the guts to visit.
These people were tough. They were hardy.
And they were really good at nicknames.
All right, I need to see just a couple more graves before I can get out of here.
No.
Nope.
No. No, not this one either.
Oh, here we go.
The graves of Billy Clanton and Frank and Tom McClowry.
These were the fellas killed at the gunfight at the OK Corral.
Yes, this is one heck of a tourist attraction, but as I'm standing here, I'm remembering the fact that the McClowrys and the Clantons still have living family who sometimes visit this place.
And they 100% still think that their relatives were murdered in the streets of Tombstone.
Easy to watch people in a movie or read about them in a book and think of them as characters like SpongeBob or something.
It's a whole other thing when you're standing in front of their actual grave and you have to confront the fact that these were real people.
Right next to Billy Clanton over here is his dad, Newman Haynes, Old Man Clanton.
Old Man Clanton was a rancher. And his operation wasn't too particular about what brand was on the cattle, if you know what I'm saying.
He and many of the other cowboys were accused of rustling cattle out of Mexico and bringing them to the United States, and also massacring some Mexicans down in a canyon.
I could be misremembering this, but I'm pretty sure that Old Man Clanton himself was killed in an ambush when the Mexicans were waiting for the cattle rustlers to come back.
Makes you wonder, since he died so violently just a few months before the OK Corral, if that wasn't part of what was wrong with Billy and Ike Clanton.
Your dad just gets violently murdered, and then the Earps are all up in your face telling you how to live your life.
I'm not saying they were right. I'm just saying, one can understand why you'd be in a bad mood.
Like I said, Boot Hill Cemetery is a very famous tourist attraction. You know, the whole Lester Moore tombstone and all that kind of stuff.
So it is interesting and fun in a way, but it's also very sad.
And on that happy note, we're going back to Tombstone!
All right, day two in Tombstone.
It's the middle of the week. You'd think that no one would be here.
But you would be wrong. There's people everywhere down here.
Well, I take that back. There were cars everywhere. And there's some people.
Yesterday I got a little sidetracked by going in the mines and concentrating pretty hard on the history.
Particularly the history of the OK Corral.
But let's not forget that as much history as there is in Tombstone, this place is, in fact, 100% a tourist trap.
You got outlaw t-shirts,
Jack Holliday's Emporium, the Silver Strike Winery,
and everywhere you look, cowboys.
Allen Street is the main thoroughfare through Tombstone's historic district,
and it is pretty much littered with gift shops.
They got t-shirts and cigars,
Indian jewelry.
Pretty much everywhere you look, there's something awesome.
Ooh, this looks pretty good. Madame Mustache
purveyor of pleasure.
Things to tickle your fancy.
Wonderful things everywhere.
Yes, the Old West is fun.
Sweet t-shirt.
Oh, there's so many stores and so little time.
Most of these stores have signs inside that say no photos.
Which basically means no filming either.
Whoa, look at this train store.
They've got everything in here.
Look at this. It's the Jimmy Crack Corn guy from Pee-wee.
I don't have the space for it, but I want this. All of it.
I love miniature things. And what's better than miniatures that move?
That is awesome.
I love touristy gift shops. The older the better, and the more hand-painted old signs, the better.
Something about hand-painted signs speaks to me. It's like folk art.
Howdy, partner. Check out my guns, and check out my bell bottoms. Oh, yeah.
I'd go inside this one, but I think that's my ride.
This is what happens when you call an Uber in Tombstone.
I'm in aboard the old stagecoach here.
Hey, this is nice. Roomier than I imagined.
Just waiting to see if any more passengers would like to come along.
Nope.
Just me.
Over here on the right, today we have the Longhorn Restaurant and the Branding Iron. In the 1880s, this was the Bucket of Blood Saloon.
Ooh, Bucket of Blood.
Just looking for stuff.
This is awesome. It's just me.
Out the right
I have
side
my own narrator.
Arrived in Tombstone and declared, every tombstone deserves to have an epitaph.
This stagecoach is a lot slower than I imagined it. It's like that scene in Office Space. Definitely not a quick mode of transportation.
It's getting a little weirder now because we just left the dirt street and went on to the regular street.
I'm in a stagecoach going down a modern street.
Are you hearing me okay back there?
Yep.
Okay. The home of Dr. George Goodfellow.
Ooh.
He is the doctor that patched up Virgil's arm in Kenneth and Morgan when he was shot in the back. The chain around the front of Doc Goodfellow's was used to connect those wagons together. They gathered a mob outside this courthouse, broke through the doors and overpowered the guards, and escorted Mr. Heath down to that telegraph pole. And strung him up.
Hey, we saw his grave this morning.
Coming up on the left, we have a wood fence along with the Tombstone Mustachery.
Tombstone Mustachery?
Ooh.
Well, heck yeah, that was a lot of fun.
I just rode an old-timey stagecoach through Tombstone. By myself.
Awesome. Uh-oh. We got some outlaws over here.
They better be careful.
The marshal's here, too.
Ooh, now how about that mustachery?
I've been feeling a little underdressed since I've been in Tombstone.
There we go. That's better.
Now, what other trouble can I get up to? Uh-oh. What's this? What's this?
It's the Earps. They're headed to the OK Corral.
Dude, there they go. Into history.
It's actually pretty surprising that the Earps ended up being the heroes of the story. Figure that they left town soon after the OK Corral gunfight.
And all the Cowboys' buddies still lived in the town for a long time.
I guess having several movies about you definitely helps your reputation.
One of my favorite things about Tombstone is how many little saloons are still in town.
Some of them are for tourists, but some of them are more for the locals.
And there's all kinds of colorful characters in there.
Now, as cool as Tombstone's historic district, you know, downtown Allen Street is, there's actually a lot more to the town.
It's quite a bit larger than you would expect.
And if you're willing to walk far enough, you could see things like this. Look at this place, Virgil's Corner Bed and Breakfast. The reason it's called that
is that the house that Virgil Earp used to stay in Tombstone, was right here on this corner.
Sadly, in the 90s, some youngsters were playing with fire, and it burned to the ground in about 20 minutes.
Luckily, just across the street, catty corner from it, is another house that's still standing.
Pretty small house, but with a pretty big history.
Because this house right here is none other than Wyatt Earp's house.
Look at that. Wyatt Earp's house, now lovingly restored and I think used most of the time as an art gallery.
Appears to be closed today. Those darn Earps, they run off.
According to local historians, this is where Wyatt Earp lived. His brother Virgil lived right over there across the street. His brother James, the Earp that you never hear about, had some property over yonder.
But then this is the really weird part.
If Wyatt Earp walked out his front door or sat on his front porch, he would look across the street and see this little house.
Doesn't look like much, right?
Wyatt's neighbor's house. Weird.
But according to the signs in the window, this house was owned by Pete Spence.
Pete Spence was one of the cowboys, and he was living right across the street from Wyatt Earp.
Those two dudes could stand on their front porches and glare at each other from across the street.
And either because his cowboy homies put him up to it, or Pete Spence really couldn't stand looking at Wyatt Earp anymore.
He is allegedly one of the guys that shot Morgan Earp in the back.
Just missed assassinating Wyatt Earp by like that much.
And ambushed and maimed Virgil Earp, crippling him for life.
Pete Spence was not a very good neighbor.
Judging by the fact that this place is closed a lot of the time, not a lot of visitors notice that Wyatt Earp's house is still standing, but it's a great place for a fun pick.
Wyatt freaking Earp.
Look at this guy.
Would you want to mess with this guy?
I don't think so.
Whoa, check out the old abandoned Tombstone High School. That looks pretty cool.
I would love to be allowed to poke around in there.
Oh, what's this? What the heck is all this across the street?
Oh my goodness, what the heck is this place?
I love this sign already.
Weird stuff, cool junk,
I'm in.
What is this?
I love stuff like this.
Look, a cowboy bathtub. Hey, wait a minute, how come there's dead bodies in every single one of these? What, do the baths kill the cowboys?
Oh my goodness, what are these?
Cowboy tikis? Epic.
Ooh, here's some barbed wire in case you wanted some tetanus.
Ooh, check out this rusty old bed.
Definitely springy, all right.
They have an odd number of pet cages out here.
Weird, so much old junk.
Anybody need a toaster oven?
How about some spray paint cans?
Something for the ladies, perhaps?
Whoa.
The inside's even crazier than the outside.
Whoa, they got a zillion license plates in here.
Little tools, a cow skull.
You tell me that's not art.
Even a popcorn dispenser.
I want this. Ooh, look, it still has bags.
Wow.
Chaps and boots.
Even these little Julios.
That is a store worth stopping into.
That place is freaking awesome. What's even more awesome is this museum across the street.
Unfortunately, it's not open today.
This is one of the best ones. They have a lot of the Earp's actual stuff in there.
Well, something for next time, I guess.
Let's see what else we can go see.
Good old Tombstone. They got the Good Enough Mine.
The OK Corral.
I'm surprised they don't have a street named Just All Right.
Everything in this town closes really early, so there's not much time left today.
This looks promising.
Check this out. Half the stuff that I've seen here before is closed today, but there's some other stuff that's open.
That I've never seen before.
Yes, this looks awesome.
Very promising indeed. And oh, what's this?
Well, looky what we have here. A fun pick.
What a fun one.
Okay, this place is awesome.
Oh my gosh, look at the shooting gallery.
Oh, heck yeah. Wonder what that guy's in for, huh? Should I try my hand at this?
No, that usually doesn't turn out well for me.
Awesome, thank you.
Okay, you can never have too many gunfights. What just happened?
They just iced that dude.
Don't get bad enough Irish for one day.
Howdy! Howdy, folks!
Howdy!
Buckskin Frank Leslie?
I'm Ringo, ignorant wretch. Okay, if you want it that way, Ringo, you ignorant wretch. I got a bone to pick. With you! I could deliver stables to the man with a low slung gun just like yours sold him a mule. Hey, there was an X right there just a sec. Hey!
Hey, Miner, you know what? You're right. There was an X.
Hey, mister, you can't walk away like that. You're nothing but a horse thief! Call him a horse thief!
Horse thief!
Together! Okay, horse thief!
Horse thief!
Mule thief!
Paper covers rock, I get my mule back! You step that rock out way too soon, and I'll work on that with you. You see that rock covers paper, or, you know.
Hey, shut up!
Bam!
Comes the marshal.
He sees the body.
The way you're getting out of this town is over my dead body.
Wait! Stop! This is serious!
You know what?
Hey!
Terry.
Hey, the bad guy can't win. Ooh. What's going on out here? Weird.
Oh, there we go. Yay! Bad guy dead.
Nailed it.
This is definitely the most random part of my tombstone visit.
Just tip for the actors.
Appreciate it, man.
That was so weird.
Little gunfight, little cantina.
This place is so cool. Look down here.
We're back, golly. It's the man.
Are you kidding me? There's a mini golf course out here.
Look at this.
There's a lot more mini golfing in the Old West than I expected.
Mad Manners mini golf.
Well, I know what I'm doing next time I come to Tombstone.
Ooh, and how about this? It's the old jail.
Huh, this must be where the sheriff used to sit. And whoa, look at this guy in here.
What you in for, partner? Stealing the putt-putts?
Cheat at mini golf? Heckle the show? What?
The strong, silent type.
Come on, speak. Speak!
I have the strongest feeling that once I leave, he's gonna start moving and talking.
Come on, old Pappy. Speak!
Nothing.
Oh, look at this.
A tombstone cat. You're kidding.
Everyone I love leaves me.
Hey!
Look at that. Look at all this hay.
Hey, what's going on in here?
What is this? Where in the world have I ended up?
A wigwam? I don't think I'm supposed to be in there.
I better get out of here before they charge me $400.
Oh, thank goodness. They've got panning for gold.
No western town is complete without panning for gold.
Or the most essential fun pick.
Well, that was awesome.
Old Tombstone Western Town.
Well, dang, there was a lot more I wanted to see that I just never got to.
The Gunfighter Hall of Fame is all locked up.
Oh my gosh, though. One more thing is actually open.
Yes! The Rose Tree Museum.
I know, Rose Tree Museum sounds awfully boring, but inside of this place
is a freak of nature.
Past the small gift shop and museum,
which surprisingly contains very little information about roses, but a lot of information about a pioneering family from Tombstone.
You come out to this yard, climb up this red platform,
and feast your eyes on
the world's largest rose bush.
Look at the size of that rose bush.
A young Scottish bride who came to Tombstone and once was a lodger here in the home of Miss Amelia Adamson
sent her a little piece of some of the plants that were sent over from Scotland for her.
You know, I really like staying at your boarding house. Before I had my own house, here's a little rose bush for you.
That was back in 1885. And for all the time since, no matter who's owned the property, they have kept this going.
This rose bush is now a rose tree, and it's getting pretty close to 150 years old.
In the 1930s, supposedly Robert Ripley visited this inn,
wrote about this huge rose tree for Ripley's Believe It or Not.
And then the Guinness Book of World Records came along and confirmed this is the largest rose bush slash tree in the world.
Apparently when Ripley came here, it was a quarter of the size it is now.
It's now over 8,000 square feet.
And when it blooms in the spring, they take away as many as 5 truckloads of trimmings.
Look at this. This is amazing. I'm 6 feet tall and I can stand up under some portions of this thing.
The caretaker inside told me that this was originally planted against a shed, which it eventually knocked over.
It's a little bit like being in the mine walking under this thing.
And speaking of the mine, look at this. The trellis was made out of all kinds of little bits and odds and ends that they found from the mines.
Look right here. This is a piece of track right out of the mine.
Once upon a time that held up ore carts. Now it holds up the world's largest rose bush.
Boy, when you watch that Kurt Russell movie and get all excited about Tombstone and then you plan your visit,
you don't expect to see this, but when you see it, it's kind of amazing.
The world's largest rose tree.
Dang, and it looks like they still have even more room for this thing to grow.
Check that out. They give you this little postcard of it covered with the little roses that grow on it. And apparently they have a contact list of people waiting to be called when it blooms so that they can come visit.
As Quentin from October Sky would say, that's prodigious.
I didn't think my day in Tombstone would end with the world's largest rose bush, but there you go.
You never know what you're gonna get.
What a trip.
Oh yeah, there's also quite a sizable
museum here in the former Rose Tree Inn.
Mostly the belongings of one family that's been here since the 1800s.
They've got a lot of interesting stuff in here.
Just hanging out in the old boarding house.
Doesn't feel haunted in here at all.
All right, I'll have to explore more of this later. They're closing up.
Time for me to hitch my wagon and head on out of town.
Well, thank you for coming with me. I hope you had a little fun.
There's a lot. A lot more to do in Tombstone.
There is a lot. A lot. A lot more left to do in Tombstone.
But sadly, I'm running out of time.
That's okay, though. We will definitely be back.
In the old west.
So make sure to subscribe. Check all the links down below.
And that'll help me get back even sooner.
Quite a few places left in town to see.
We're not super friendly with cameras on this trip.
But believe me, I've already collected quite a few email addresses.
So hopefully when I come back,
we can step in even deeper into the wildest town in the west.
For now, though, just by watching this video,
you've done your duty.
You can go home and sleep.
You can hear me? Don't play dumb with me, guy.
Must be Amish.
He's shunning everyone.
God dang it, how many times am I gonna have to tell you to get that cigar out of my face? It's like I'm playing cards with my brother's kids.